Hi, my name's Mark Saber, and welcome to the Folkestone Underground Gang Executive, or FUG for short, Base of Operations, aka my mum's house, but don't tell anyone that.
Can you put the clothes out of the washing line and keep the dish and empty the dishwasher? I'm meeting Philippa and Lucy, so I already made dinner. It's in the oven.
Okay, Mum, can you be quiet? The camera people are here. It's very important. No criminal gang will expect a base of operations to be in their mother's house. But all the special units are going to do this soon. Also, free home-cooked food. Who doesn't like that?
This is the main nerve center with lovely pictures of me as an infant. This is my partner in crime, or should I say partner in justice, Tony Humperfunk. Say hi, Tony.
Hi, Tony.
Me and Tony have been friends since the academy, and we've been partners for over 10 years. No, not in that way. The captain usually sits over there, but he's on vacation at the moment, so it's just us two at the moment. There were up to other people in the force, but they couldn't cut it.
I thought they left because of the Christmas incident.
I don't fucking talk about that.
Yeah, couldn't cut it. Me and Tony are actually currently working on a very important case. Let me set up a presentation to show you guys. This is Kendra, 23. She's the biggest narcotics dealer in Folkestone. She's not like your typical drug dealer. She built her small town drug empire by using nefarious adult sites such as Maybe Fans, Kindler, and Bump and Grind to sell her narcotics. We have been on this elusive wrench's tail for months, gathering information to build up a case so we can get this pink-haired punk behind bars. We may have broken a few rules to get to this point, but it will be worth it. Our captain is not best pleased that we have broken or twisted a couple of regulations and rules to get to this point, but he doesn't know better. He's saying that if we don't catch her before he gets back from vacation, we'll be transferred to different departments.
Luckily, we've been working on a sting operation to catch her in the act. This will give us enough evidence to put this neon green gimp behind bars.
What can possibly go wrong? I should really grow up my moustache though. So Tony, are you sure this is what young people actually wear?
Yes, I've done a lot of research into youth clothing, and I'm pretty sure that's what they wear. I even asked my stepson, and he said it's a-okay.
Are you sure? I mean, not to be mean or anything, I know you worked really hard on this, but I don't think the youth today would wear this t-shirt. I mean, I was amazing last night, just ask your mum. That's something an immature douchebag will say, man, come on!
Relax, young people love to rebel against us, but anti-establishment. We're a form to school.
Enough! I don't hear about your female underwear antics anymore. Oh, God. Okay, this t-shirt will have to do. Let's do the checklist.
Okay, let's do it. The wire.
Check.
The list of words and phrases meaning cocaine.
Check. Okay, let's get this done so I can get out of this stupid outfit.
Wait, you forgot this.
What is it?
It's a Monster energy drink.
Ooh.
It's the pineapple punch flavour.
Oh.
It's what the kids are drinking these days. My stepson drinks like 10 a day.
Yeah.
Yep, he's an addict to caffeine. You want to try?
Yeah, sure. Might not even be that half bad. Yeah.
Whoa!
Oh, tastes like unicorn and don't ask me how I know! Okay, let's go do
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Hey girl, you want to blow the chalk on you?
Colombian nut?
Britney Snort?
Nose candy? Miley Cow?
You know, the white star!
You dirty old man!
Stop!
Help me, Tony! Well, that could have gone better.
Gone better? It was your dumbass that blew the whole operation.
Hey, hang on a minute. I was frustrated, okay? She obviously knew that I was an undercover cop because of your stupid, idiotic outfit.
My outfit was not the cause of the problem. It was your dumbass that made the problem. And we could have got good evidence to put Kendra behind bars. Hello?
Okay.
That was my informant. She's just told me that there's a drug deal going down with Kendra tomorrow in the park.
Well, fan-bleeding-tastic. Excellent job, twat. Tony. I'm definitely not going to go undercover tomorrow, so break out the FUG drone. Kendra's sitting on that bench over there. Fire's walking towards her.
Should I launch the drone now?
Launch the drone!
I'm losing control of the drone.
I know.
Oh, I can't do anything.
You got it, man.
Oh my god.
You got to regain control.
No.
No, not her. Oh.
The hell are we going to do now? We've really fluffed up this whole operation.
Who knew that the Fukang surveillance drone 1701 needed servicing regularly? Blame Sam, the tech guy.
Blame Sam? We won't be here to blame anyone. Captain LaFraud is not gonna be moved to a different department. We're gonna be kicked out.
Wait, who are those shoes belong to?
You two have a lot of explaining to do. Mark, you come with me. Tony, I'll speak to you later.
Tony, the captain has given me some good news and some bad news. The good news is that he has given us 3 more days to catch Kendra. The bad news is that if we don't catch her in those 3 days, we will be moved to different departments and split up.
Oh, that's real bad.
I know. That's why we've got to work hard and get that pink head. Hello again. We've actually got some good news. We've found the location of K-Dog's house. Basically, we found this picture of her on Kindle where she was posing against a window. Through that window, we revealed the address and house number of the house next door. And we gave that picture to the Kent Intelligence Unit and they found the house as being number 21, Kona Road. And do you know who lives on the opposite side of number 21? That's right. That elusive son of a bitch. Also, Tony's informant has given us some information that's very valuable. He said that in her home, she keeps all of her narcotics there to sell. So when we catch her, we'll get a ton of evidence.
Yes. I'd like a Big Mac and apple pie, please.
Let's get that son of a bitch.
Can I have some biscuits?
Okay then. I pick the lock, you stay guard.
Oh, I got it.
Alrighty then.
Alright.
My colleagues used to call me the pick master. Not prick! Pick master, because I was so good at
I got it!
What?
It's under this rock.
Okay then.
Yeah.
I'll open the door. Here.
I'll let me do it, Mark. You're taking too long.
No, I can do it. Right. I can do it. Right. I never buckle under pressure before. Not now.
Move, Mark. I'm doing it.
Fine. Oh. Okay then. We search all rooms to find that son of a bitch.
Yes. She's running.
Oh, good point. Okay, let's get that bastard. Hardest, coarest of shits. And 1 trillion heaven dollars in stack form. What a monster. Tony, what are those?
Oh, I forgot mine. These are my mum's. She said they're for restraining and pleasuring.